So welcome back students to the JCE learning. Okay, so today we are going to discuss a session over design of tension member. Okay, so we'll solve one more problem for how to design a tension member with welded connection. Okay, so in the last session we had discuss and we have solved one problem, that is again over design of tension member. I think we have solved two types of problems, that is design of single angle and design of double angle with bolted connection. So in this session we'll discuss how to solve if the connection is provided with welding. Okay, so I'll read out the statement of the problem. Design a tension member to carry a factored load of 340 kN. If it is welded to a gusset plate of 8 mm thick using fillet weld as shown in figure. Okay, so we have to design a tension member to carry a force of 340 kN if it is welded to the gusset plate of 8 mm thick. Okay, now if you see the sketch here, so this is the angle. Okay, this is the angle connected to gusset plate. Okay, and we have to design a weld here along the member. Whatever the angle section will get, along that we have to design a weld here. Okay, and that weld is carrying a force of this, not the weld, actually the member, the carrying a force of 340 kN. Okay, now we'll start with the solution now. Okay, so the first step is we have to find out the area required, that is, so according to the given data, force is given as 340 kN. Okay, area required as per, again same, gross section of yielding. Okay, have to find out the area required as per cross section of yielding. Okay, so again it is TDG is equal to AG into FY upon gamma M naught. Okay, so again here the AG is the TDG is 340 kN. Okay, so by using that you have to find out the area. Okay, so therefore AG is equal to 340 into 10 to 3 to make it in Newton into gamma m naught 1.1 divided by Fy 250. Okay, so from that you got the area as 1496 mm square. So it's my request, you have to check the calculation. Okay, now increase the area by 20%. Increase the area by 20%. So therefore AG required, this will be now by increasing 20%, 1496 into 1.2. okay, 1.2, so you got the required as 1795 mm square. Now you have to refer steel table and you have to find out a single angle of area having more or less 5% more or less 1795 mm square. Okay, now we'll go back to the steel table and we'll find out the area. Okay, so here, so I have selected 80 by 80 by 12. Okay, so adopt ISA, that is single ISA 80 by 80 by 12. From steel table you have to add up ISA 80 by 80 by 12. So for that the AG provided will be, the AG provided will be 1781 mm square. So the AG provided will be 1781 mm square. Okay, so after selection of member, the next step is you have to design a connection. So next is design of connection, design of connection. Next is design of connection. So we know that in size of welding, in size of welding in welded connection, that is size of weld. Okay, so again here we have to find out what is minimum size of weld and what is maximum size of weld. So here first, yes, minimum, which is nothing but the minimum size of weld from table 21. So if you go to table number 21 of IS 800 2007, if you want to write IS 800 2007, table 21 of IS 800 2007, we can easily find out what is S minimum required. So therefore S minimum is given as 5 mm. Okay, by as per the table number 21, you have to choose S minimum as 5 mm. Okay, then S maximum. S maximum is, again it is T1 minus 1.5. Okay, so what is T1 here? The T1 is the thickness of thicker part of plate and angle. The thickness of thicker part between gusset plate and angle. So gusset plate thickness is 8 and the angle thickness is 12. So thicker part is 12. So you have to take 12 minus 1.5. So you got 10.5. What? 10.5. So you have to choose the size between 5 mm to 10.5 mm. Okay. So hence, adopt S is equal to 8 mm. So we will adopt the size of weld is equal to 8 mm. We will adopt the size of weld is equal to 8 mm. So therefore the effective throat thickness, effective throat thickness is equal to T is equal to K into S, which is nothing but 0.7 into 8, which is nothing but 0.7 into 8, so which is equal to T is equal to 5.6 mm. So you got T is equal to 5.6 mm. So we got the thickness of weld as 5.6 mm. Okay. So now the next is, you have to find out the strength of weld. You have to find out the strength of weld. Okay. Then, so for that, what is the equation? We have to find out the strength of weld. So therefore, now the design strength, design strength of weld, the design strength of weld FWD, that is for fillet weld, design strength of fillet weld FWD is given by FU by root 3 into AW divided by gamma MW. FU by root 3 into AW divided by gamma MW, where AW is what? Area of weld. So that is length of weld into effective throat thickness, LE or LW into effective throat thickness. So we know the effective throat thickness as 5.6, so we can find out FWD in terms of LW. So FU is 410 divided by root 3 into area is LW into T is 5.6 divided by, so we'll assume it is a side weld, okay, not shop weld. It will, we will assume as a side weld or field weld. So we'll take it as gamma MW is equal to 1.5. Okay, so I think you remember gamma MW is 1.25 and gamma MW is 1.5. So this is for shop weld and this is for site weld. M 1.25 you have to use for shop weld, 1.5 that is more factor of safety for site weld. Okay, so we got it is 883.73 newton per mm. So we got 883.73 newton per mm. Okay, this is the in terms of LW, sorry, 883.73 LW newton per mm. So this is the ultimate strength of weld, okay, for fillet weld. Now for next we'll see, now we have to find out LW. Okay, now if I draw the sketch quickly, we'll draw the sketch here. Okay, so we have the member like this. I'll show it here. And this is a centroid, and this along the centroid the force is 340 kilonewton. Okay, this angle is connected to plate. So if you want to draw, I'll draw the cross section also. Sorry, draw the cross section. So this is plate. Okay, and over that plate we are going to provide an angle section. Okay, over that plate we are going to provide, this is our angle section. Like this, okay. Then we have to design a weld. We have to design a weld here. Okay. So weld will be, so here, so weld over this plus this. Okay, so again we call it as this as LW1 and LW2. Okay, we call it as LW1 and LW2. This part we have studied in welded connection, how to calculate LW1 and LW2 for truss member. Okay, okay, and this section, this is 80 by 80 by 12, angle section is 80 by 80 by 12. This way it is 80 and this way it is 80. Okay, so it is 80 by 80 by 12. Okay, now so we know that, so this is P1 and this is P2. So what is P1 P2? P1 is force offered by LW1, P2 is force offered by LW2 for a given size of, that is 80 mm leg. So now again the next is, after having the sketch we should have the distance, these distances from centroid to the toe, again from centroid towards the junction. Okay, so for that again you have to refer the steel table. Okay, I'll show you, because one it is important. Okay, now if you go back and if you refer the steel table for here 80 by 80 by 12. Okay, and if you go back here, so we have to find out the CXX and EXX. Okay, you can check here. So you got the CXX as 24.2 and EXX it is 55.8, if you go and check. Okay, because it's equal angle. So again I told you what is CXX. So CXX is what? So it is from the junction towards the center, from here to here it is CXX. And what is EXX? From junction towards the toe or the end of the angle, so that is EXX. So these we have got, these two values we have got it as from steel table. If you go back and if you check, I have shared a soft copy of steel table also on group. Okay, so this we have got as 24.2 and this we have got as 55.8. And both together if you add, you will get 80 mm. If you could not get 80 mm, then it is wrong. Okay, your whatever data you have chosen, those wrong. Okay, then we'll calculate M1, P1 and P2. So for that we'll take summation of MA will equal to 0, summation of all the moments at A. So we'll consider this point as A, summation of all the moments at A is equal to 0, or about P2. So for that, minus, because it is anticlockwise, minus P1 into AT plus P, minus P1 into AT plus P into 55.8 is equal to 0. So from this we will get value of P1, that is 237.15 kilonewton, 237.15 kilonewton. Okay, so next, so therefore now we know that P1 plus P2 should be equal to 340 kilonewton. Okay, because whatever the force are there, it is a 340 kilonewton, that should be shared by P1 and P2. Okay, so we know the P1, so you can easily find out P2. So therefore P1 plus P2 is equal to 340. So you can easily find out, therefore P2 is equal to 102.85 kilonewton. P2 is equal to 102.85 kilonewton. Okay, so we'll go back again our formula. Okay, so you have got the FWD is equal to, you have got, we have FWD is equal to 883.73 LW newton per mm. Now what we'll do, we'll equate FWD once along with P1 and once along with P2, so we can easily find out LW1 and LW2. So by equating, FWD is equal to P1 and FWD is equal to P2, so we will get, so we get LW1 is equal to 270 mm, LW2 is equal to 120 mm, LW1 270, LW2 120. So I'll superimpose this over the sketch. So you got LW1 as 270 mm and LW2 as 120 mm. I'll write with the different sketch. So you got 120 and 270. Okay, this is regarding the connection. Okay, so after designing connection, we have to go for, what is the next step? You have to go for analysis. The next step is analysis of member. Okay, so whatever the member you have selected, okay, and whatever the connection we have provided according to the member, so we will check for safety. Okay, next is analysis of member. Okay, next is analysis of member. To check its design strength, analysis means to check its design strength. So that is, analysis means the design strength of member is again least of first strength due to yielding, strength due to yielding of gross section. This is important again, strength due to yielding of gross section, which is given by TDG is equal to AG into Fy upon gamma m naught. Okay, TD is equal to AG into Fy upon gamma m naught. So AG is the area of angle what you have provided. So that is, I think we have got 1781 into Fy is 250 divided by gamma m naught is 1.1. Okay, so we got the value for this is 4 now at 4.77 kilonewton, which is more than 340 kilonewton, which is more than 340 kilonewton means, so therefore okay. So the member can carry a force of, means before yielding angle 80 by 80 by 12 can carry a force of 404.77 kilonewton, which is more than 340. The applied force is 340 kilonewton, which can carry, that this angle can carry a force before yielding 404.77 kilonewton. Okay. Now next is softer strain due to yielding. The parameter or the strength you have to check, that is second one is strain due to rupture at critical section. Strain due to rupture, which is given by TDN is equal to 0.9 ANC FU divided by gamma ML plus beta AGO into FY upon gamma M naught. This is the basic equation. Okay. So here we have to find out what is ANC and AGO. Okay. First of all, we have to find out what is ANC and AGO. Now because it is a welded connection, so no deduction of bolt hole. So you can easily find out ANC is equal to AGO, that is equal to, means connected leg and outstanding leg both are same. So AT minus, I think the thickness is 12, so 80 minus 12 by 2 into 12. Okay, so you will get 888 mm square. Only ANC and AGO changes when, if the, in case of welded connection, only when the two legs are different. Now both the legs are same here, so ANC and AGO remains same. Okay, now next is you have to find out the value of beta. Okay, so for value of beta we should know what is LC and what is BS. What is LC and what is BS? So I think I told you. Okay, so LC, that is length of connection. Okay, so here we have, the length of weld LW1 and LW2. Okay, so length of connection, which length you have to consider? So I told you have to consider the longest between these two. So I think here LW1 is more, so longest. So we'll take LC is equal to LW1, that is 270 mm. Okay, LC is equal to 270 mm. And then BS is equal to nothing but W. In case of welded connection, as for code, BS is nothing but W. So BS is W, so that is 80 mm. And by using these two values, and when you go back and substitute in the LC beta equation, so we'll get LC beta is equal to 1.30. You have to utilize these two values in calculation of value of beta, and you will get the beta is equal to 1.3. Okay. After that, the next is you have to go back. So TDN is equal to 0.9 ANC is 888 into FU is 410 divided by gamma ml is 1.25 plus beta is 1.3, AGO is 888 into FY is 250 divided by 1.1. So you got the value of TDN is equal to 524.50 kilonewton, which is more than again 340 kilonewton. Therefore, okay, understood. So you got again, which is more than 340 kilonewton. So again, this section is safe in fracture. Now we'll check for block shear. Third is strength due to block shear. So that is TDB1 and TDB2. So for TDB1 and TDB2, again we required value AVG equal to AVN. Okay. So I told you again the AVG will remain AVN only in case of welded connection. Only in case of welded connection. Okay. Then ATG is equal to ATN. ATG is equal to ATN. So what is AVG again? I told you. So the fracture here, so the failure will take place here. So this part, okay. So I'll show with the pencil. Okay. So the failure will take place. The failure takes place. So in longitudinal direction, the fracture will start from here and also from here. The fracture will start from here and here. Okay. And the whole section will get crack like this. Okay. So for this, what we are considering? We are considering the summation or the average. So we are going to consider means average of, means it will come somewhere here. So the section will cut longitudinally like this and vertically like this. Okay. Longitudinally like this and vertically like this. Okay. So here, so we'll calculate that. So AVG, AVN, ATG, ATN. AVG, AVN, ATG, ATN. Okay. So for AVG, the longitudinal length is, we have to take average. So that is average of 270 plus 120 divided by 2. 270 plus 120 divided by 2 into 12. Okay. And ATG, ATN, we have to take the vertical. So that is 80. The leg length is 80 into 12. Okay. So we got the area as 2340 mm square and 960 mm square. Okay, so you got this calculation. So after that, so when you use these values and substitute back into the formula, so TDB1, TDB2, so you got the answer as, so TDB1 we got 590.43 kilonewton, TDB2 has 617 kilonewton. Okay, it's a request you have to check. So these two together, it is TDB. So you have to choose the least between these two. So we got TDB out of these two, we got the TDB least as 590.3 kilonewton, which is again more than 340 kilonewton. Therefore, okay or safe. So here we got to know that in all the three cases, our section, whatever you have provided, it is safe in all the three conditions. Okay. So again, it's a request you go through the video, okay, and try to solve, note down and solve. And if you get any queries, you can contact me. Okay, thank you.